Well, hello there. In this video, I am going to show you how to make an embroidered birth announcement. It is actually possible to make this, what you're seeing on the screen, from scratch. So I'm going to take you through exactly how I did this. One thing I want you to notice is how this file looks before I save it out as a PES file to stitch on my embroidery machine. You can see that I have it color sorted. So I have the coral thread color, the lavender lilac, and the aqua. So it's all sorted so that it stitches out nice and efficiently. Okay, so let's get started. One thing I want to mention first is I only have the Essentials component installed. So we're doing this only with Embrilliance Essentials. The first thing I'm going to do is I am going to create a new page. Now, I kind of drew out what I wanted it to look like beforehand. So you can see here I have a little sketch to help me plan kind of how I'm going to lay things out. And I did a little playing with fonts, so I know what fonts I want to use. But what we can do is I want to make this work in like a 5x7 hoop. So I'm going to go to this little button here, which will allow me to merge designs in from the library. And just as a guide, I'm going to use this applique square and I'm going to stretch it out so it gives me a frame for my 5x7 space. Of course, I can use the squares here as a guide as well, but it's just a little easier to see. So let's either stretch it out or we can just type in, we want this to be 5 inches wide. And do you see it scaled it up proportionally? That's because my lock button was on. I'm gonna unlock that and make it 7. All right, so here's my 5x7 space. Now, of course, I don't want to make this my final design exactly 5x7, because when you have a 5x7 inch hoop, you can't actually stitch to the limits of 5 inches by 7 inches. Okay, so this is just a guide here. And if I want, I could actually lock it just so I don't end up moving it around. The first thing I'm gonna do is I'm going to put my name in, and the baby's name is Eloise Rose. And the font that I chose in my was block condensed, just because it's like longer, taller letters. I just like the way it looks. So I'm going to move that up to the top and I might stretch it out a little bit because that's probably the most important thing, the name of the baby. Now I can play with proportion more later. Then I'm going to add the last name. So I can choose my letter tool, and I like my own personal font that I made. You may not have this one. Of course, you can do this with the built-in fonts. I like the interplay of two different fonts. Usually something that works well is two very different looking fonts. Right now, I'm using a serif font for Eloise Rose. For the other details, I'm going to be using Eloise Rose is a sans serif font. I'm going to be using a serif font for some other details. And the serif font I want to use is called Jasmine. Again, you can do this however you want. This is my font. You can buy it on my site if you really love it. So the last name is Smith. And so I like the interplay of kind of all caps, a little bit uppercase, lowercase, but we don't want to go too crazy with so much variation because we want it to feel cohesive. Now my letters are kind of spread far apart, so I'm going to decrease the spacing of, decrease the spacing between my letters. Okay, that's fine. And I also want to make this a little bit, well, I think I want to make it a little bit smaller, and that's fine. Now when we're moving around letters, you can inadvertently move one letter. If I just hit undo, if you want to move the whole group, you just have to click away from the green boxes and you can move it as a group. Okay, there's where I'm going to have Smith. And then let's go ahead and add some of this other data. The next part we're going to do is the weight in pounds and ounces. So I'm just going to take this Eloise Rose, I'm gonna copy it, command copy, command paste. If you're on a PC, that's control copy, control paste. And it's 6. And I'll move that over to place. And the other number I need to create is 11 for 6 pounds, 11 ounces. I will command copy, paste, move it over. And this will be 11. Now, I want to make sure I'm lining these things up properly. I can select both of them and choose utility, align, and let's align their bottom marks. Apply, and can you see how that kind of just shifts it right into place? Beautiful. Now, let's just move this down. I probably want to align it to Smith too, but I'm not going to bother doing that right now. I'm going to take the Smith letters and I'm going to copy these and paste them. They're on top of each other now. And instead of Smith, I want it to say LBS. And I want this to be a lot smaller. So I'll say, let's make it about 40% of what it is right. Oh, I'm sorry, not that. We'll do 40% and 40%. If I lock it, then once I go 40, the other, oh no, it didn't, it didn't lock. So we'll just type 40 and 40. Okay, so now it's small. And we can rotate it manually. I'm gonna say undo. The easier thing to do would be just this button right here to get exactly 90 degrees. And then I'll slide that over into place. 6 pounds, that's a little bit big. Let's make it 30%. 30 and 30, okay. And I'm gonna zoom in a little bit so it's easier for me to place this. 6 pounds. And 11 ounces. So move that into place. And again, I will probably want to fix my alignment. All right. So we'll take all these things. I just shift selected to grab all of them and drag it into place. All right. Next, I need to get the time. I'm sorry. Next, I'm going to get the weight. So let's just copy the 11 and the ounces. Copy, paste, move that down. And it is 21.0 inches. All right. Move that over. And we need to change that to inches. All right, and then we need the time. So I'll take this, copy it, paste it, move it over. So I'm gonna pan using the spacebar tool. It's a good shortcut for panning. And this would be 6:53 p.m. 6:53. And I can't remember how I did. I think I just did this all like this. Let me look at how I did that. Oh, I did it like the other one. Okay, so let's cut the PM part. We will take the inches that I've copied and move that over, and we'll make that PM. All right, now all we need to do is the date. Again, I should probably use my utility for alignment. Okay, so let's zoom out a little bit and I'm going to copy and paste this and let's put the date down here, which is 2/13/25. And I'm not going to put any characters between these, and I'll show you why in just a second. So 2/13/25. Okay. Now, this is kind of boring looking right now. Let's make this a little bit more interesting. I want the name to be more prominent, so I'm going to select everything but the name and just bring it down a little bit. All right, because I also have a lot of space too. So I'll bring that down and I'm going to take the name and let's make it more bold. Eloise Rose. Okay, I like that. Now let's add a little bit of flair here and there. All right. So how did I do it on my other one? Well, do you see how I have this line work in there? Actually, I think I kind of stretched everything out to give it a longer appearance. And I also added some hearts too. So let's go back And we will, let's stretch everything out just a smidge. So I'm going to select everything except Eloise Rose, and I'm going to stretch it out just a bit. Okay. All right. So Smith is taller than the 6 pounds, 11 ounces. So let's move these guys up a little bit, and let's add, like I said, let's add a little bit of flair. The way that I'm going to do that is I'm going to introduce an element that comes in the library, so you have it for free. Let's merge it in, and it is called, what is it called? It's called, we're going to look under motifs, and it's candle wicks. Okay. And that doesn't look like much, but what's cool about it is I can stretch it out, and that looks terrible, right? But it regenerates itself. Beautiful. So let's rotate that, and let's maybe put this under the name here to give it a little bit of division, and I could just stretch it out to be the right width. And let's use it again. Copy, paste. And then maybe I'll put it right here to kind of butt up against, to make it kind of interesting here. All right. That looks cool. Maybe we'll make this a little bit taller so it kind of takes up a little bit more space. And then maybe I want to use it. How did I do it in my other one? I put it between these two elements here and at the bottom. Okay, got it. So let's do that. We will copy and paste it, and we'll rotate it and shrink it a smidge to kind of divide these two elements. All right. And in my other one, I somehow had more room over there. I don't know. Then I'll use this, copy, paste, and bring that down there. And then I want to make the dates. Let's kind of squish this over a little bit. And I'm going to take the 5 and move it over just a bit, and the 2 and move it over just a bit, because I want a little bit more space between the letters, because what I'm going to do is I'm going to separate them with a dot. So I can take this text right here, I'm going to copy it and paste it so it's on top of each other, and instead of this text I'm just going to do a period, and I'm going to make this period the color, just to integrate the colors throughout. I'm going to make its color the same as the candle wick color. So I clicked on the swatch, and I have palette selected here because this is already in the palette. That's the coral, okay? And now it's hard to see and grab. I'll zoom in a little bit. And now I'll bring it right here. I like the way that looks. Copy, paste, put that there. Okay, now I have a weird little space right here, but what I could do is I could fill it with an element that's part of the library, which I also have for free. So we'll go back to our library, and if I look at Ike under motifs, there's a little heart. Okay. Now, Embrilliance brought it in as red, but I want it to go with my current color palette, so I'm going to select the color swatch, go to palettes, and choose my coral color. Okay, now in my layout, I did something a little bit differently and ended up with another heart up here. I could, of course, add another heart if I want to and put it up here, I don't know, and shrink it down if I wanted to. Now, I also have more of a square shape. If I want to just extend this whole thing and get it to fit more in a 5x7 shape, I could select everything and stretch it down. And then my letters are gonna be a little bit more elongated. But the cool thing about that candle wick border is that it stays as circles. So I think this looks pretty good. I'm pretty happy with that right now. But it's 3 colors, it's 3-color design. I no longer need this applique square, so I'm gonna unlock it and I'm going to delete it. And then what I'm gonna do before I stitch it out, well, 2 things. One, I probably want to save it as a .be file so that I kind of, if I ever want to do another one like this, I can go in and just change the details. So I'm going to do that. I'll say save as, and actually I only really need to save the, sorry, file, save as. I only need to save the working file. So I might want to call this, let's just put it on my downloads for now, and let's just call this a birth announcement. Okay. The beautiful thing is, if it's a BE file, .BE file, I can just go in and edit it for another name. But if I want to stitch it out, what I'm going to do to make my life easier is I'm going to go to the utility and then color sort. Say new view. And now it created another page here, but here's the cool thing. It put all of the same colors together. So this is the version that I would save as a stitch file. So I could save it as a .pes file, bring it to my embroidery machine, and just stitch it up. So that's how I would create a baby announcement embroidery design. If you want to learn more about Embrilliance Essentials, which is what I'm using right here, or any of the other Embrilliance products, I have some courses on Embrilliance, and I have tons of videos on YouTube for you to check out. Thanks!